This session is foundation work and part of the terminology section. We will be introducing you to the language, terminology, and definitions for some of the basic concepts, functions, and processes that you are going to be putting into use during the rest of the course. First, let's review the structure of this session. In the section, definitions, we will first try to clarify the use of the word data. We will then look at the terminology surrounding fields, labels, and lists. And lastly, we will straighten out some concepts around characters and their mappings that will help prevent unwanted data messes. In this section, we will look at some of the many different terms and phrases that exist within the world of data and information management. We will be using these throughout the course, and it is important that you be familiar with when and how to use them. Let's focus for a moment on some common words and phrases that contain the word data. All of the phrases that you see here include the word data. But are they all the same? And if not, then what is the difference? Database, database language, database program, data cleaning tool. So what is a database? There are, as you can see, many definitions, but what they all have in common is the theme that a database is a structured and organized collection of data and/or information held on a computer. Everything else in the list is just a way to help you achieve data nirvana. Let's dig a little deeper into those other terms. Let's take a look at the phrase database language. According to the Oxford English Dictionary, language is the method of human communication consisting of the use of words or symbols in a structured and conventional way. For our purposes, database languages and their close allies, the array languages, are the way by which a human communicates with a computer to manipulate and move data around. Examples that you may have come across are Java, Sparkle, SQL, and Python. They are simply methods used to define and create tables, views, and queries, and also allow users to access, update, store, and move data around. Now let's look at the phrase database program or software. Again, going to the Oxford English Dictionary, a program is a set of related measures or activities with a particular long-term aim. In this context, a database program combines and presents functions and features for manipulating data together in a unified interface. Examples that you may have come across are Microsoft Access, FileMaker Pro, and Oracle. So database programs or software are grouped utilities which allow a user, via a database language, to store, manage, query, and report data held in the system. The last term with data in is a data cleaning tool. Data cleaning tools are systems whose utilities focus on the manipulation of data with the aim of increasing fitness for use. Examples that you may be familiar with or will learn about during the course are OpenRefine, MATLAB, and spreadsheets. A data cleaning tool should assist the user in the discovery and repair of messy data in order to increase quality. Continuing on with some more terms that you will need to be familiar with, we will look at the differences between the terms field, label, and list. You will often hear reference made to field or column names and field labels or headings. Often they will be used interchangeably. However, they are in fact different things. Field or column names refer to the actual column in the database table. They are often short, not always in plain language, sometimes computer generated. But in a properly formed database, they are always unique. Field names are almost always used by database languages because they avoid ambiguity. Labels and headers, on the other hand, refer to the human-readable versions of the field names. Most often, you will see these in the graphical user interface of your software and on exports and in reports. In some software, you can in fact have different labels to the same field on a user-by-user or group-by-group basis. As you work with your data, you will come across the phrases drop-down list and controlled vocabulary, and on the surface they can appear to be the same. Indeed, they are both powerful tools to help you keep your data clean, but they are different. A drop-down list, also sometimes called a lookup table, is a data entry element that is created in your database software. It allows you to select a value from a predefined set of options. These options may also be generated from the data itself on the fly. A controlled vocabulary, on the other hand, is a very strictly defined domain-specific set of values that should be applied to a particular field. They are an integral part of a well-defined standard. Such values can be used in a drop-down list, as mentioned previously. In this next section, we will look at what the term character means in relation to data and computing. As a reminder, computers see in binary. Everything that you type in is held in memory as a series of ones and zeros. The computer does not see the repertoire of letters and symbols on your keyboard. It needs a map to translate the character set that you would type or write into its binary language and then back again to show to you on the screen or a printer. This map is made up of two parts: the coded character set and the character encoding. Each symbol or glyph is assigned a numeric value, and that number is then converted to binary. In this example, we see how character encoding is used to map the capital letter A in the Western alphabet. The ASCII value for the capital letter A is the decimal number 65, which in hexadecimal is 41, and in binary 01000001. Every character has a mapping. Try mapping your own name to binary using the link at the bottom of the screen. In effect, what is happening is that when you type into a keyboard and save a file, the software that you are using will select an encoding to save with it. When you open that file again, the software needs to know which encoding or map to use to redisplay the information back to you correctly. This table shows you some examples of the more common character encoding and character sets. So why is this important to you as a data custodian? Let's say that you need to translate the start of Hamlet's soliloquy, "To be or not to be, that is the question," into French. You save the file with a text editor that uses the encode in Latin 1. Then you send it to a colleague to check the translation. Voila! When they open the file in Microsoft Word, however, this is what they see. Mon Dieu! There are some unexpected characters. You forgot to tell your colleague that you were using Latin 1 as the encoding. Microsoft Word on their end was set to use the encoding UTF-8. The maps did not match. And depending on the software, the data may in fact be irretrievably corrupted. In review then, we have looked at the differences between the phrases database, database language, database program, data cleaning tool, and also between field names and field labels, drop-down lists and controlled vocabularies. And lastly, we looked at repertoires, coded sets, and encodings as they related to characters. We have shown that although the terms may seem similar, they are in fact very different, and the consequences of confusing them can be dire. Remember that the first step in wisdom is to know the things themselves. We often take for granted that there is a whole language associated with biodiversity informatics that is not commonplace and has to be learned. There is no shame in going back to basics and getting to grips with the vocabulary, grammar, and syntax just as you would with any new language. Thank you for listening. If you have questions on this presentation, please use the provided forum in the e-learning platform. This video is part of a series of presentations used in the GBIF Biodiversity Data Mobilization course. The Biodiversity Data Mobilization curriculum was originally developed as part of the Biodiversity Information Development Programme funded by the European Union. This presentation was originally created and is narrated by Sharon Grant, with additional contributions by BID and BIFA trainers, mentors, and students.